weather. And so it's hard to predict. And I guess that's true in Boston too sometimes. If the ocean, you know, something's coming up from the Atlantic.
Yeah, the problem is you can't put Doppler out
in the ocean.
Better roll up the windows.
Look at this!
Is it really that rare to rain here?
We haven't had
summer?
This much rain
yes.
in weeks. And
wow.
Weeks.
It does not rain in the summer.
Well, damn.
So it is a little taste of early fall. It's probably good.
I'm surprised that there's still green thriving.
Well, look at the lawns.
I'll give you an idea.
Yeah. These people just have a gray lawn, a tan lawn. That's it.
I think you're going to be close.
I think, yeah, no matter where we are. But they know the back ways. I think that's their idea. Drive to Newburgh and then come back on some back.
You mean the three of us are going to be
coming back from Joan's house. Right. We will figure something out.
There's not, there's
maybe we'll
bridges.
Use our tools. Into another town.
Well, we're gonna come up on Sherwood before you know it.
Sherwood, okay.
That's the one thing, like, I've never driven into, like, I've driven through Sherwood on 99, but I've never driven into the town. See, that just looks like one big house.
Yeah.
They say
this had only freshmen?
Nope. No, I mean what I said. What I said was, last year was its first year. They only let in a freshman class. This year is their second year. Freshmen are all sophomores, and they're bringing in another freshman class.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So it's going to take them 4 years to fill the school, huh?
Yep. And they're not moving students. Like, students aren't transferring from one school.
So this will pretty much debut
at Balderdash High. You know,
you can stay in Balderdash.
You're going to Balderdash all the way through.
So the Hillsborough Hops are in Boise tonight.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's too long a drive.
But it's not till 7:15. We can make it.
Take your best shot. Idiosyncratic approach to business.
Yes. But if he can get,
I really
like
think
some,
I should get a job delivering.
Hold on a second.
No, if he can have some reliable.
We might get a box van from Frank and Gaston.
I'm telling you, I'm just like. Because I could like go in, deliver, and get out.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, you know what?
You, by the time. You said by the time I'm done with Portland, I'd be a beer snob. To what extent is that bad?
Not bad at all. It means you'll make better choices when you go to a bar.
You'll educate yourself a little bit, and you'll appreciate something better than a Narragansett.
Yeah.
Sounds about right.
Because if you're going to have a drink, have something that's a quality product. Maybe
that you like. But you have
that
to,
you
have
like.
To try it. I guess just have you try. And you know what? You should go start going with John and your dad and Gary. Because I see them do the tasters.
Oh,
start
yeah.
asking
Red
questions and learning.
I thought what, based on the term beer snob, snob means you are arrogant. I thought it means...
A little bit.
I thought being a beer snob means you have... Thinking you have a superior life to everyone else because you drink alcohol.
Or maybe superior beer knowledge.
I guess, possibly. And it can be subjective. To me, a beer snob, I'm definitely a beer snob in that I know what I like, and I'm not going to drink a shitty beer or something I don't like just to drink a beer. I'm okay. I'm not going to be like, oh, that's beneath me. I'm just like, no worries, I'll have water.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Like, if you're going to, yeah.
If I'm going to drink, if I'm going
to
pay for
it,
I want to enjoy it. If I'm not going to enjoy it, I'm okay with not having it. So, yeah, it's not to the literal snob term.
Oh.
And extra bonus points for supporting local businesses, which I know that Phil and those guys like to do because they go to local breweries.
Yeah, I'm not going to support, like there's one beer that made a really good product, but they sold out to Budweiser.
Yeah.
So we don't drink 10 barrels anymore.
Yeah.
There's, you know, they were
very popular.
They were very popular.
And apparently they kept all their brewing knowledge.
Thanks for the elaboration.
Yeah.
The money goes to AMI.
I'm like, no!
She was born. My little sister got separated from us, and we were at the big pyramid place outside Mexico City, Teotihuacan. And it's 9 years, it's a mile and a half road, and we're here in the Alamama.
May peace prevail on earth.
I thought that was really funny until Declan was well past the Herald thing.
Did he go
first?
Did he go first? Late bloomer.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's good chalk art, actually.
That's very good chalk art.
That's one of the stories I used to read on the November trip. Do you remember that? He's like, I don't want to leave with you every time.
We can go down to McMinnville, then we can start heading south back up 47 from there.
Put it this way, one of those lightning tasting rounds, I spent so much time on the phone with my father that he wanted to end the call.
Tony?
Yeah.
Grandpa Tony,
and you know, he likes to talk. We were waiting out there so long that Grandpa Tony was done with the call. D-U-N done.
he's not great Grandpa Tony yet, huh?
Thank God. Bad man.
Thank God what?
He's not great. for Tony to be great grandpa Tony, you would have to have children.
Or any of your
could that
your
even
siblings?
Happen?
Does that sound like a good idea?
Me?
Oh.
Yeah. Does it sound like a good idea for you to have a child?
Yes, but could it? Do you think it could happen?
Trust me, it's not a good idea. Because then, you don't even do for you. All you do is for them.
Well, I've done a lot for me enough in my life.
247. It doesn't stop.
247.
What does that mean, 247?
24 hours a day, 7 days a week. 247-365.
247-365. No, it's 867-5309.
Yeah, but we can sing that. We can remake that song.
Who should I
kind of like the $6 Million Man. We can make it better.
Sure you can.
247-365.
Jenny. Oh, there they are.
Do you know I saw this tour at the Boston Garden?
Really? What year?
1977. February 77.
Wow.
Or 76.
What'd you
I think
get?
It was 76.
I gave
it. No.
I think I got 2 bucks.
Never knew that.
Could have been 77. I think more likely 76. I don't know. If I had to choose, I'd say 76.
Night of the Opera?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's about right.
Boston Garden. Thin Lizzy warming up.
I saw Queen in 81 at the Seattle Coliseum.
Oh, yeah.
Game tour.
Wicked cool.
It was awesome.
I'm telling you, I was totally and completely unprepared for Freddie Mercury. Freddie Mercury rocked my world in ways that I didn't know my world could be rocked.
There's a biopic about him coming out.
In Roswell?
Yeah, that was.
Well, but here it was more like 53 or something.
And they took the remains up to Wright Patterson in Ohio. Dude, I'm totally on board with that. You know it's true.
It is very good.
14 day tour to Boston.
Well, the thing is, like, Boston doesn't do over 90 very often. It's just humidity. It's awful.
Yeah, but imagine 44. Late day.
with humidity.
Check that Goodwill out.
Every one of them's got it.
Thanks for alerting me.
That spider is something.
I love a giant spider on a Goodwill.
So what I do with the sugar ants, honey, heated honey. I put it in a sort of a double boiler setup.
Right.
Heated honey, and then I put in borax, not too much. Then I lay it. And I put it on a...
Okay.
You know, the original one in Oregon freaking burned to the ground. Some dude lit it on fire.
This place has
47 left.
I think this is the old train station. No.
I grew
That's the old train station right there.
You know.
Thanks to Hades' description on Instagram.